Hi, and welcome to this Lovely Loops tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Procreate to make transparent backgrounds of things that you create on paper. So if you do any lettering or drawing with ink on paper, I'm going to teach you how you can import it into Procreate, just like this. But then I'm going to show you how you can turn it into a transparent background so that you can do neat things like change the color of it or even move it around and change the background color. So let's go ahead and get started. So the very first step is taking a picture or scanning in whatever you want to modify. So I have this written out on my paper. So if I wanted it to be a little more accurate, I would scan it in, but I'm just gonna take a picture of it. So you can do either way. So first let's go into have Procreate open. I just created a new blank square canvas and I'm going to actually change the background color of this to pink just so that later on we can see what we're doing a little easier. So I just made my background color, tap on it, and choose a color other than white. Okay, now I'm on layer one. I'm going to go to my wrench icon up here and choose take a photo, which is the third one down, take a photo. So a little trick is if you tap on the photo somewhere, right now this is on my iPad, if I tap somewhere, then I can drag my finger up and down to make it brighter or darker. And then I will just take it. And in the bottom it says retake or use photo. It looks a little bit blurry. I'm going to try retaking it. All right, it's good enough. So let's choose use photo. And now it's inserting it onto my canvas. It gives me automatically some options that I can move it around or resize it. So maybe I'll just make it a little bit bigger and then I will hit the arrow to X out of that. Okay. So right now you can see that the white and the black are on the same layer. We can't edit the lettering independently, but we can see that they're stuck together. So we want to basically make the background of this transparent so that all we have is the black lettering on the pink background. So first we're going to make some image adjustments. This is all going to work best on a black and white photo, but you can use this with color images. You'll just have to play around with the settings a little bit differently. So making sure that we have our photo layer selected, go to your wand adjustments and then choose curves, which is the second from the bottom. And then this top right node here, we're going to tap on it and drag it to the left. So you can see the background of the image is getting brighter and brighter. If you go too far, it's gonna sort of take away all your black. So we want to go, I usually go about to the middle right here with that. And then this bottom left one, we're going to tap on it and drag it to the right a little bit. So that's going to, you can see it's darkening up the lettering. Okay. So go as far as you think is going to provide enough contrast. That's really what we're going for is contrast here. So once I'm happy with it, so basically this top one, I moved all the way to the middle. And then this bottom left one, I moved to one square over. Once I'm happy with that, I'm going to tap on the wand to commit those changes. Okay, just to show you the difference before, after. So it's just a lot higher contrast. So it kind of looks like we have black lettering on a white background, but they're still on the same layer. So now what we want to do is cut this black lettering off and put it on its own layer. So we're going to use automatic selection here. So tap on your selection tool here in the top left, and then automatic freehand rectangle, you need to choose the automatic option. Now we're going to tap on an area of the black in the photo. So just take your pencil and tap somewhere. Let's choose the T. All right, so you can see it sort of turns some of it white. So when you have something selected, it's going to invert the color. So anything that's black, once you select it, it's going to change it to white. You can also see that there's still a black back, like outline around where we have selected. So that's because our selection threshold is a little bit too low. So I'm going to tap on this L here. And same thing. So if I tap again and then I slide my pencil to the right, you can see at the top it says selection threshold is 1.7%. As I move my pencil to the right, it's going to increase that percentage and select more of my area. So as I keep going, it's selecting more and more of the black area and leaving less of an outline. Do you see the difference here on this L where the selection threshold is pretty high? Right now it's at 99%. The area, the outline of it is very thin compared to the E. So I'm going to tap again on the E And now it's going to make it the same threshold selection, which was 99%. Whoops. So let's tap on the E again. Okay, so it's just selecting anything that's connected to the letters. So right now the L was separate, then this area was separate. So we have ING separate from all of that. I'm going to tap on it, should select everything, and then always make sure you got all your dots of your I's and anything else that you want to select. So now it kind of looks like we have nothing on the canvas because it turned it all to white. So to put what we've selected on its own layer, take three fingers and slide down really quickly on your canvas and choose cut and paste. So now it turned back to black and we can see there's a new layer here called from selection. Then we also have layer one. So I'm going to turn off layer one and now you can see we've achieved exactly what we were going for. So we have our lettering word has a transparent background so we can see whatever is behind it. So whatever we change the background color to, the word lettering still stays the same. We still have this sort of negative image. So the white area that was around the word lettering is still there. If I deselect the lettering layer, that actually looks kind of cool. Now we have a transparent area in the middle of the word lettering. Just to show you what this effect looks like even more, I'm gonna add a new background layer that has some gradient to it. So now we have a nice gradient layer. This is just instead of having that solid blue background color, we have a gradient just so that you can see this effect a little bit better. So the way that this worked was we cut out the words lettering from this white background. So now we have a black area that's separate from the white. Okay, so one thing I notice when I zoom in pretty close here, there's still a little bit of a white edge around my word lettering. That's because the picture was a little bit blurry, and then also because of the texture of the paper, it's just not a super crisp line. So if we didn't want any white at all here, one thing we could do is, if you're happy with making everything on this layer black, like basically what we have is one additional pixel on each edge of the black that is white. So what we could do is just change all of those pixels to black. So in order to do this, you would open up your layer, so the from selection one, tap on it, choose alpha lock, and then you could change your color to black, or let's just choose blue for this example. So we already have blue selected. I'm going to tap the layer and choose fill layer. Now you can see that all of the pixels are blue, so there's no white around the edge. And that, I know that looks kind of silly now because we have a blue background, so I'm just changing my color to black, doing fill layer again, and now we have a perfectly black lettering layer that is on top of, that has a transparent background, okay? So anything we can do to change the background, and we have a whole separate tutorial on how to fill large areas of your work with color, so go check that out if you're interested in that. But now we have this as a transparent background. If you really wanted to fine-tune things, what you could do is, first of all, I would probably make a copy of this just because we kind of put in a lot of work to get that on its own layer. So I just made a copy of it by duplicating the layer. And now I'm going to hide the copy and work on my new layer. So if you really wanted to get these edges nice and perfect, zooming in, you could use your eraser tool. So just pick any eraser you want. If you want a crisp edge, you could use Calligraphy Monoline and then just erase the areas that you want to smooth out like this. But leaving it like this, I know close up it looks kind of jagged edges, but far away it looks pretty nice. There are some areas that definitely could use some correcting, so you could erase and then redraw them in with black. Whoops, I'm gonna go to my Calligraphy Monoline brush and then tap and hold on the black area to select the black color, reduce the size of it, and okay, the reason that I'm unable to draw right now is because I have alpha lock on still. So alpha lock only allows me to color where there are already pixels. So I would need to turn that off by opening up my layer, tapping on it, tapping alpha lock, and now I can draw anywhere I want. So that is how you can make some small adjustments and make your lettering transparent background using just Procreate. Thank you so much for watching. If you are interested in more tutorials about using Procreate and lettering, please subscribe to our channel.